In this video, we are going to study about the serratus anterior muscle. This muscle is a broad sheet which forms the medial wall of the axilla and it is covered by a well-developed fascia. So here you will get the axilla. So this area is the axilla and this is the medial wall. So the medial wall of the axilla is formed by the serratus anterior muscle. So when you see the origin of the muscle arises in the front by 8 fleshy digitations from the outer surface and the upper borders of the upper 8 ribs and from the fascia covering the intervening intercostal muscle. The first digitation appears in the posterior triangle of the neck and it arises from the outer border of the first rib and from a rough impression of the second rib. The lower 4 slips interdigitate with the costal origin of the external oblique abdominis muscle. So when you see the insertion, all the digitations of the muscle pass backwards around the chest wall and reach the costal surface of the scapula and getting inserted into the medial border or the vertebral border of the scapula. So the blue color line indicates the insertion of the serratus anterior muscle. So how the muscles are inserted? The first digitation is attached to an area from the superior angle to the root of the scapular spine. Second and the third digitations, maybe the fourth also, are inserted to the narrow strip along the medial border of the scapula. Remaining 4 or 5 digitations, they converge and inserted into the large triangular area on the inferior angle. So here you can see the serratus anterior muscle arises as 8 fleshy digitations from the outer surface and the upper border of the upper 8 ribs. So these fibers, they pass backwards and they form the medial wall of the axilla and getting inserted to the medial border of the scapula. So this is the medial border or the vertebral border of the scapula. Next we'll see the nerve supply. The serratus anterior muscle is supplied by the long thoracic nerve of Bell. So this nerve convey the fibers of C5, C6, C7 roots of brachial plexus. The nerve enters through the apex of the axilla behind the first part of the axillary artery and passes downwards along the medial wall of the axilla behind the mid axillary line and beneath the deep fascia. Thus, the nerve is not usually involved in the operations of axilla. The C5 root supplies the upper 2 digitation and C6 root next 2 digitation and C7 root supplies the lower 4 digitations. Next we'll see the action. When the entire muscle contracts along with the pectoralis minor muscle, it protracts the scapula around the chest wall in pushing and punching movements. So here you can see, so this is the protraction of the scapula. So this action of the serratus anterior muscle is antagonized by the contraction of the rhomboids and middle fibers of the trapezius. So these rhomboids and the middle fibers of the trapezius are the retractor of the scapula. Next we'll see the applied anatomy. Paralysis of the serratus anterior muscle results in winging of scapula. So when you ask the patient to push against the wall, the paralyzed side medial border of the scapula becomes more prominent. So this is winging of the scapula.